something like this.
FNAF, thanks not the social keys. FNAF, thanks not the social keys. FNAF, thanks not the social keys. FNAF, FNAF.
Something like this.
FNAF, thanks not the social keys. FNAF, thanks not the social keys. FNAF, thanks not the social keys. FNAF, thanks not the social keys.
Hello, I'm David Wallace, a mechanical engineering design professor at MIT.
So, FNAF, facts, not assertions, please.
My father once said to me, have a plan and be ready to change it. And that really stuck with me from an early age. The ability to be flexible and pivot when something isn't going the way we planned is crucial to the design process and really is a skill that we try to foster in each of our design students. In our product design class at MIT, teams explore hundreds of product ideas, you might say plans, before deciding which final single product direction they'll take.
Next week, you're going to be deciding on your product direction for the rest of our product development process. But it's about working together and really making the best informed decision that you can. Welcome to our Sketch 1 review.
In this process, every team member will invest, really believe, in ideas that end up on the cutting board. Each team member will have plans and then change them. How do we make these decisions? This is a hard question, but FNAP is one thinking tool that we provide. So FNAP, what that means is facts. Not assertions, please. And so a fact is something that's really a known or demonstrated truth. And an assertion is really something we believe in, that we can often very convincingly make sound like a fact.
Okay, big day. Yay.
FNAP really comes to the forefront in one key decision-making meeting. Up until now, the larger team has been broken into four sub-teams, each with their own product idea that they will be pitching to the team at large. They've poured a lot of energy, thought, and care into these products. So they're highly, highly invested in each of their ideas. But now they need to come together to look at the facts and set aside assertions to choose the final product idea that they'll all rally behind for the final prototype launch.
That is a 50-50 split.
We actually have signs up in our meeting room with giant letters, FNAP, when teams are making decisions.
We all remember our FNAP principle. What does it stand for?
Not assertions, please.
And we almost make it like a chant, perhaps like a game, a dance, a song, FNAP, that you can remember. Some teams make FNAP hats. And so when somebody in a meeting is starting to make assertions stated as fact, they get the hat.
I just think there's no way the steel would ever bend.
So it provides a really fun and kind of tension-relieving way to have this hard discussion of, okay, what do we really know? What are the things that we hope we know? And agree on how to sort them out to balance the risks or, you know, the knowns, where we feel like we're safe. And you have to take some risks, but you have to have a kind of reasonable handle on that before you commit too much.
We're gonna vote, and we're gonna vote for the one we want. Heads down, heads down. Okay. Slim suit, raise your hand. Auto sketch, raise your hand. Okay, here you go. Chosen slim suit.
This year's yellow team reached a consensus to move forward with one of their proposed products. But after learning about a critical shortcoming related to user needs, they pivoted to another of their product ideas. Then, after getting some user feedback, they pivoted again back to one of their original ideas. the fish feeder.
For testing purposes, I'm in contact with three fish farms who have all said that they'd be willing to help us test.
It's really easy to go down a path following things that are asserted beliefs rather than facts, and it can lead to trouble. And in design teams in our class, that happens from time to time, and the students eventually realize it, and then after some struggle become very good at pivoting. And that's really the lesson of FNAP, where you've learned it and internalized it, and you're going to remember it. Sometimes, despite our best laid plans, ideas break. It happens. It's the cost of doing business in a messy physical world. But in our quest to tame it and forge a better world, we must be open, humble, and confident enough to recognize when to change course. Can we all apply the idea of FNAP to work together and be more open to change? To have a plan, but remain flexible enough to change it when presented with the facts? All assert, yes, I think we can. Be on the watch to identify assertions. Diligently search for facts, known truths. Make choices understanding which information is fact and which is hope. Be honest with yourself. Challenge your ideas. Have a plan and be ready to change it. And as always, keep playing seriously.